Good day, Steve here. Got another project for you. Now, if you got a situation like mine, where I've got a pony wall, my kitchen's over here, wanted a TV in there. I don't have a TV upstairs, mine is downstairs. But trying to find a TV mount that would work in a situation like this is pretty hard. I couldn't find one. So what do? You go out and build one. Kept it really simple, basically just a couple pieces of tubing here, a mount, you're done. This one here, I can spin it around if I want to go over and watch from the table, do whatever I want with it. It can move this way. But I'm going to give you a bit of a close up on some of the details, and then we're going to head to the workshop and I'm going to show you how I build it. Pretty simple here at the back how I mounted it. Just basically just an X. You have to do a little bit of mapping out to get the holes in the right place, but that's pretty minor. And you can see that the wires run down the tube. I'll go to the front and I'll show you what I did there. All right, now we're in focus there. So on the front, basically the wires just run down the tube, cut a little bit of a notch in there, and then they go into my little PVR thingamadoob. Built a little thing over top so I can store stuff on top. And that's all there is to it. So let's head to the workshop. I'm gonna show you how to build this. So I want to be able to mount a TV on a pony wall, so I'm going to mount it on the top of the pony wall, and I want to have it so that it can swivel both ways, this way and this way. So what I've come up with is just a couple pieces of pipe, one that fits inside of the other. Now, I'm kind of fortunate I have enough stuff laying around that this piece of pipe fits really well in here. It's hard to find something like that. Like this piece of pipe is, I don't know, 2-inch skid 160. It's got like 1/4-inch wall on it or something like that. Most people don't have that laying around. You can go and get yourself a telepost, you know, one that's in your basement that holds your main beam up. You can go to the hardware store and buy those. They're fairly inexpensive. That would work just fine and dandy. So my whole idea here is I'm going to build a kind of an X to mount on the TV. That's going to mount onto here. This is going to mount onto here. And then I'll be able to give her a little bit of a swivel. Now what I've got here is just a little piece of tubing that I'm going to mount inside this piece of pipe. And I'll just run a bolt in between, and that's what's going to give me my pivot up and forward and up and down. So I'm going to start out today with the TV mount. Basically all I've got here is just some 1.5 by 3/16 flat bar. I'm going to build an X and I'll drill it out, and then what I'll do is put a bolt on the back side, and that bolt will come through here, and then that's how I'll mount the TV. Now when you start out with some fresh materials, there's a slag on here, and if you weld on there you can actually get some pretty crappy weld. So give yourself the best chance of getting a really nice looking weld by grinding that off. So what I do, I don't use my grinder because that's just going to damage things up. I use a flapper pad, and this is just a 40 grit, and I just ground this up. So what we're going to do is, I've got it fortunate enough to have a flat working surface here. I just got it clamped up here. I'll just tack it. Before you go ahead and do that, make sure you square it up. You don't want to look bad. Better turn some gas on. There's our X. You can weld it in from behind, but what I did was I actually beveled the edge here. So I've got an okay weld. If we were holding up a truck or something like that, you'd want to probably weld both sides, but I'm pretty happy with that. I'll clean it up with the grinder. And from here, what we're going to do is drill our holes. Of course, I've already planned that out. I've drawn measurements out, and we'll set that up and we'll drill those holes out on step two. Okay, we got the holes drilled. I prettied up the corners a little bit with the grinder and took the slag off. Paint will stick a little bit nicer. So we'll move on to the next step, and that's going to be putting this little piece of tubing. And what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to grind a groove into this piece of pipe here, set it up so it gives me a little bit more room to weld, and it'll look a little bit nicer. So I got the groove cut here for this little piece of pipe. Now you might think that, well, maybe a guy could have just gone through the middle, but the problem with that is then you can't get any cords through there. I want to be able to still bring all my cords up, and that's my thinking on this. So we'll get her all straight here. That'll mount on there. We'll get a little bit of play, not a whole bunch. I want to come down more than I want to go up, so that'll work out fine. Okay, so this is going to be the bottom of the first pipe here, and it's going to go on our base like this so our cords can come out. All I did was just drilled a 1-inch hole here and then just went down with my zip cut, of course, you saw that. We got this all done. As you can see, I just prettied it up a little bit. So now we got a little bit of up and down, and this is the hole here where... Amazing how much junk gets collected. That'll mount on like that, and onto your TV. We're good to go. So the next step, we'll clean this all up, and I'm gonna tack that on there. And then we're gonna build a washer, basically to go around here, which will be our stock. Okay, so we just about got, we've got everything all tacked together. I've actually given this thing a try to make sure it worked. But this is our next piece. We need something to keep this from sliding too far. I was fortunate enough to find this little collar, or my material's thick enough I could just cut a little ring here. But if you got thin material, you're gonna have to build a kind of a washer to go around here so you could tack on and get the height that you want. Now, fortunate for this one here, I can move this up and down, change my height. You might want to try and find something that you can do that with. Okay, now you can see that I've got her all tacked up. We've tried it. Everything seems to be pretty good.
So what we're going to do now is weld her all up, give her a little bit of a sandblast, paint job, install.